Spiritus. Veni Sancte Spiritus. Veni Sancte Spiritus.
Good morning, and welcome to the Cathedral Basilica of St. Louis. Today, we celebrate Saturday in the fifth week of Easter. Our music may be found in your worship programs. Please stand and join in singing our entrance hymn, Now Thank We All Our God.
Wondrous things are stored. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
St. Louis, along with my brother priest, Monsignor Dennis Staley, our Vicar General, who today, 45 years ago, was in this cathedral being ordained a priest. So thank you, Monsignor Staley. With our deacons, our men and women religious, and all who gather. This is indeed a joy to mark the completion of this phase of your lay formation. Over these past 3 years, you have endured the pandemic, numerous Zoom meetings, more than you probably care to have attended, and other obstacles. But in the journey, you have persevered in your formation and your love for Jesus Christ, our Savior. Along with you, I am personally grateful to Sister Kathleen Ronan for her leadership of the formation and all those who have instructed you over these past 3 years. It's a joy also to welcome Charlene Cushnan back here for the commissioning service. Charlene has moved to Washington State, but she continues to serve there with the foundation that she has gained from lay formation here in the Archdiocese of St. Louis. As we are so conscious of our union in Christ with all who have gone before us, we remember Maria Lucretia Knapp, who also went home to the Lord in January, and Cindy Yadamek, who went home to the Lord this week. May God give to them rest and peace in that eternal kingdom. Standing before our God, brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our sins, seeking God's forgiveness and mercy. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy upon us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, whose will it is that all should be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth, look upon your abundant harvest and be pleased to send workers to gather it, that the gospel may be preached to all creation, and that your people, gathered by the word of life and sustained by the power of the sacraments, may advance in the path of salvation and love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles.
Paul reached also Derbe and Lystra, where there was a disciple named Timothy, the son of a Jewish woman who was a believer, but his father was a Greek. The brothers in Lystra and Iconium spoke highly of him, and Paul wanted him to come along with him. On account of the Jews of that region, Paul had him circumcised, for they all knew that his father was a Greek. As they traveled from city to city, they handed on to the people for observance the decisions reached by the apostles and presbyters in Jerusalem. Day after day, the churches grew stronger in faith and increased in number. They traveled through the Phrygian and Galatian territory because they had been prevented by the Holy Spirit from preaching the message in the province of Asia. When they came to Mysia, they tried to go on into Bithynia, but the Spirit of Jesus did not allow them. So they crossed over through Mysia and came down to Troas. During the night, Paul had a vision. A Macedonian stood before him and implored him with these words, "Come over to Macedonia and help us." When he had seen the vision, we sought passage to Macedonia at once, concluding that God had called us to proclaim the good news to them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "If the world hates you, realize that it hated me first. If you belong to the world would love its own. But because you do not belong to the world, and I have chosen you out of the world hates you. Remember the word I spoke to you. No slave is greater than his master. If they persecuted me, they will also persecute you. If they kept my word, they will also keep yours. And they will do all these things to you on account of my name, because they do not know the one who sent me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
One has studied church history. During Vatican I, on the papal vote of infallibility, there's a description of a thunderstorm hitting Rome outside during the vote. And indeed, as we gather today here at the Cathedral Basilica of St. Louis, seems like the same event happening, that thunderstorm, a reminder of God's great power. That power that shows through in nature, that power that shows us that we are called to something beyond ourselves. And indeed, that is what we celebrate here today, that your hearts have been touched by the Holy Spirit, that you've responded to that call of the Spirit in the lay formation program. And as you began that program, you did not know where it would lead you. You did not expect to be studying and being in formation during a pandemic. You did not expect that you would be wedded to Zoom meetings in such a way that they came on and on and on and seemed to thwart the formation process. But thanks be to God, they didn't. You've learned that living the Christian life, living as disciples of the Lord Jesus, is not an easy task. It is one that demands the very depths of our being in order to follow him. We listen to the words today of John's gospel, and as Jesus is preparing for his own death, he is preparing his apostles for their mission, of what they will do to follow him. But he tells them, the way will not be easy. There will be many burdens. He even uses the words, the world will hate you, just as it hated me. So Jesus knew that if his disciples were faithful to the mission to which he had commissioned them, and faithful to the Holy Spirit who prompted them, that their lives would not be easy. Indeed, their lives would be difficult, but they would be faithful to that mission. We know that many of them suffered martyrdom because of preaching the kingdom of God. We see that continued in the Acts of the Apostles as St. Luke chronicles the history of the early church and speaks of the missionary journeys of St. Paul, who met with many obstacles, obstructions, threats of death, being thrown out of towns and villages. But yet, Paul was persistent in preaching the good news. Not only was Paul persistent in doing so, he was able to draw other disciples to follow Christ as we hear of the call of Timothy in today's first reading. We know that Timothy, too, went on to be a great disciple of the Lord Jesus through Paul's and others' examples, and was able to preach that good news that had been preached to him. We celebrate that call that was given to the first apostles, that Holy Spirit that was given to them, is the same Holy Spirit that continues to guide the church today, to call men and women to service in the name of the Lord Jesus, to call men and women to learn of the richness of our faith, of the path to salvation, of the way to which our Savior calls us to go. Indeed, Jesus promised to be with his church always, even to the end of time. He never promised that the journey would be easy, but he did promise that remaining faithful to him, the journey would be meaningful. The world hates those who are witnesses to the Lord Jesus because we stand as a mirror to the world. We stand as those who speak up for life in all of its forms. We stand as those who want our church to be a beacon of light to a world that is sometimes immersed in such darkness. We stand up to the forces of evil that are so unleashed in our world today that we almost become impervious to the violence that is reported to us through so many media each and every day. But Jesus calls us as a people of hope, that in the midst of this darkness, in the midst of evil, in the midst of the world hating us, we bring the light of love. We bring the light of the Lord's peace. And we bring that hope that nothing in this world can give. Time and time again, we see the emptiness that happens in our world, the emptiness that is derived from hate and division, the emptiness that is derived from loneliness and isolation. And each one of us, as followers of the Lord Jesus, are called to bring the Lord's healing peace to those different situations, whether they be within family or community or in our world. We are commissioned to bring that light of Christ to others. This morning, we experience this thunderstorm, darkness at this hour of the day. Right on cue. But we also know the clouds will be parted, the rain will stop, and the sun again will shine upon us. Nature reflects the wisdom of God. And so as we celebrate this commissioning of you as lay ministers in our church, we give thanks to God for your witness of faith, for your persistence through very tough times over these past 3 years, through your witness in being able to complete this formation program because of the Lord's call to you to serve others in the community. And we ask that God continue to illumine your lives with the light of his risen Son, to illumine our world that even though sometimes it does not want to hear the gospel message, that you would be a mirror to show the world the light of Christ, so needed. And that in all you do in service, you may be guided by the Holy Spirit, who indeed brings to all of us the joy of serving the Lord and following in his ways.
All who have come to be commissioned today, please stand. Karen Balicus, Joan Bates, Rick Bates, Mimi Bell, Jane Wexler Brown, David Burley, Joy Camp, Margot Carr, Abby Cole, Lisa Cosgrove, Mike Chrysler, Thomas Daugherty, Karen Dennehy, Eric Dennis, Christopher Donart, Jana Dore, Mary Ellen Downing, Kevin Downing, John Duenwald, Michelle England, Jack Friebersizer, Patty Framuth, Malinayali Galindo Binay, Elliot Goldfarb, Carol Golwas, Diane Lynn Therese Grass, Dawn Gross, Laura Gawali, Pamela Hager, Nancy Hebert, Sherry Himich, Jenna Hoffman, Denny Hoffman, Lisa Hollenbeck, Jennifer Hotze, Barry Jacobson, Mary Johns, Andrew Johns, Don Keg, Therese Keg, Kelly Kennedy, Dolores Klaesner, Susan Koster, Mary Jane Farrell Lane, Jessica Livingood, Beth Loeffler, Leanne Ludicky, Bill Lerman, Phyllis Lerman, Robert Marino, Wendy McGowan, Sam Memmert, Chris Mertz, Jean Mills, Kathleen Milner, Kimberly Nelms, Chris Nelms, Marcia Norfleet, David Ott, Harry Partle, Modesta Perales, Shelley Peterson, Sally Price, Douglas Prize, Lisa Prize, Gary Prisgoda, Diane Pugh, Elizabeth Reckenberg, Kim Reed, Esperanza Rodriguez, Kevin Santander, Rosemary Schelling, Brandy Schmidt, Bonnie Schmidt, Jim Schneider, Judy Schneider, Mary Schoenhoff Eulery, Terry Lynn Schrader, Janet Schwent, Sharon Shanks, Lisa Shea, Diane Slinkard, Connie Stelzer, Tisha Stevenson, Rebecca Stainer, Patricia Taylor, Angela Timms, Tina Tlopik, Chai Tran, David Tranny, Tony Trull, Esther Vail, Neil Veneman, Bobby Von Ritter, Dee White, Martha Whitehead, Nancy Williams, Bob Williams, Rosemary Werther, Mike Werther, Carolyn Yandel, Charlene Young Cushon, Angela Zander, and deceased Maria Lucrezia Knapp, Cindy Yadamek.
Dear brothers and sisters, you have now completed the 3-year lay formation program and are prepared to fulfill your commitment to provide 3 years of service to the body of Christ, the Church. Today, by the renewal of the promises made at your baptism, I invite you to affirm your faith in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and your intention to faithfully serve the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, Do you renounce Satan and all his works and all his empty promises? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, the creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the dead, and life everlasting? This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it, but in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.
Joyfully now.
By his passion, death, and resurrection, Christ has redeemed you, giving you at baptism a share in his divine life and incorporating you into his body, the church. At confirmation, you receive the Holy Spirit with his sevenfold gifts, preparing you to share in his mission for the salvation of the world. In the Holy Eucharist, Christ continues to nourish you with his word and his body, joining you in his sacrifice of love. This day, by virtue of the grace of the sacramental life active within you, I send you forth as messengers of the gospel. And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep you by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen. Let us congratulate now all our lay ministers. All would please stand. Dear brothers and sisters, filled with paschal joy, let us pray more earnestly to God that he who graciously listened to the prayers and supplications of his beloved Son may now be pleased to look upon us in our lowliness.
Or persons recently baptized and those who have come into full communion with the Catholic Church, that they will be supported by Catholics whose love and example will draw them deeper each day in union with Christ and his body, the Church. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of nations, that the influence of women and men who bear the divine life within them will encourage them to work for peace and respect for the value and dignity of every human life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the poor, the sick, the grieving, the homeless, for those suffering physical, emotional, and spiritual anguish, that they may experience the love of Christ through the prayers, the compassion, and merciful care of those who are being commissioned this day. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the women and men being commissioned today, who were joined to Christ by the waters of baptism and filled with the gifts of the Holy Spirit in confirmation, may recognize their service as an offering through Christ, and with Christ the sacrament of salvation, the Holy Eucharist. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those who have died, for our pastors, our teachers, our family and friends, for Maria Lucrecia Knapp, and for Cindy Yadamek, our companions in lay formation, that they will be led to the joys of heaven by a merciful Father. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O God, who know that our life in this present age is subject to suffering and need, hear the desires of those who cry to you, and receive the prayers of those who believe in you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, God.
Bless you.
Pray now, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Look, O Lord, upon the face of your Christ, who handed himself over as a ransom for all, so that through him, from the rising of the sun to its setting, your name may be exalted among the nations, and in every place a single offering may be presented to your majesty through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
lift up your hearts.
Lift
us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with all the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we were nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Louis, St. Vincent de Paul, St. Rose Philippine Duchenne, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Mitchell, our Archbishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace in unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace, Archbishop. Thank you. Good words.
Lamb of God, you
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word.
Oh,
Let us pray. Nourished by these redeeming gifts, we pray, O Lord, that through this help to eternal salvation, true faith may ever increase through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As we conclude this Mass of commissioning today, once again, to all who have been commissioned, who have completed this 3-year formation program, our congratulations and our thanks to you for your witness to the Lord in being commissioned on this day. To Sister Kathleen Ronan, Religious Sister of Mercy, to all who have worked along with her, to Joyce Jones, and to all who have, through these 3 years, shared their wisdom with you, we are grateful. I'm grateful to my brother priests and deacons and men and women religious for joining us in such numbers today so that we can affirm and support you in your commitment in service to the church. And finally, to your families who have been very patient with you over these 3 years, I'm sure. We're grateful to all of them for their support of you and their encouragement of you in all of this process. And now let us ask for God's blessing.
And just a reminder for the reception that is to follow, please exit out this side of the cathedral. You'll go out the door, turn right, and enter the Boland Hall. You'll find some people along the way to give you directions, but it's very, very simple. The easiest way, again, is to exit on this side of the cathedral.
And our thanks to Monsignor Henry Breyer and his staff for always hosting us so graciously in their welcome to us here at the cathedral. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.